I'm Lynn Goldstein, a registered dietitian. Iron is one of the most plentiful metals on Earth, and it isn't just for building skyscrapers. Iron is an essential building block for our own structure. We need iron for everything from transporting oxygen around the body to regulating cell growth. Normally, the body absorbs about 10% of the iron in foods we eat. But iron is so vital, our bodies are able to recycle the iron it needs from our old red blood cells when it has to. Talk about sustainable construction. Without enough iron, you can develop a condition called anemia. The World Health Organization ranks iron deficiency as the number one nutritional disorder. Nearly 80% of the world's population may not get enough iron, and as many as 30% may have full-blown iron deficiency anemia. When you're anemic, your body doesn't have the iron it needs to make hemoglobin, found in our blood cells, and myoglobin, found in our muscles. It's the iron in these two proteins that gives both blood and muscle its red color. Hemoglobin and myoglobin are responsible for carrying and storing oxygen in our body. When the body doesn't get the oxygen it needs, it can cause a range of symptoms like pale skin, fatigue, and vulnerability to infection. Cold hands and feet, dizziness, headaches, and even an irregular heartbeat can also be symptoms of anemia. Not having enough iron can be caused by a number of things. Blood loss, including internal bleeding over time, say from an ulcer or certain tumors, or even in some women having heavy periods, poor nutrition, the demands of pregnancy, or an inability to absorb enough iron from foods. Meat is an especially iron-rich food, and the form of iron in meat is absorbed especially easily by the body. It's called heme iron, and it's also found in liver, seafood, and poultry. Plants contain non-heme iron, which is less efficiently absorbed, but are still great choices. These include dark green leafy vegetables like spinach, beans, and iron-fortified foods like certain breakfast cereals, breads, and pastas. Even some dried fruits like raisins and apricots, as well as certain nuts and seeds, can pack a hearty iron punch. Research has shown that your body absorbs iron more easily when iron-rich food is eaten with foods containing lots of vitamin C. Good choices for those include fruits like melons, strawberries, kiwis, and mangoes, and vegetables like broccoli, peppers, tomatoes, cabbage, and even potatoes. Too much iron isn't good either. In fact, it can be deadly. Hemochromatosis, or iron overload disease, is an inherited condition in which too much iron builds up in the body. Despite the complicated name, it's one of the most common genetic diseases in the US. When someone has this condition, during digestion, the body absorbs a lot more iron than it needs and then has no way of getting rid of it. The extra iron is stored in the body tissues, especially the heart, liver, and pancreas. Over time, iron levels can become dangerously high, and those organs can be damaged or even fail completely. Taking too many iron supplements can also lead to iron poisoning. Trying to adjust iron levels yourself can be hazardous. See your doctor if you suspect you might have either too much or too little iron in your system. As a registered dietitian, I know that designing a healthy diet can sometimes feel as complicated as constructing high-rises, but eating a variety of fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and lean meats is a great foundation to build on.